All right, so, well, what to say? There's no message. There is nothing to say. What happens, what seems to be happening is whole and complete by simply being itself. It has nothing to do in that sense with those romantic spiritual ideas, which is always assuming there to be an experience of something very beautiful. But there is no such thing. Experiencing itself, so to speak, is illusory. It's the dream. I am aware and I'm experiencing something real that is the dream. And the sense of unfulfillment, this energetic assumption that something is missing, is part of that dream. It just belongs to that impression to be a person, that something isn't quite it, isn't quite right. They just go instantly together. And of course, the person tries with all its seeking to find an answer to this. It tries to get rid of this. This too just is part of that setup to be a separate person, the sense of unfulfillment and the attempt to do something about it. There's nothing wrong with that really, because apparently to be someone feels uncomfortable. And it's exactly the person's dilemma that it can't get rid of that sense. That's why all seeking fails in the end, or just leads to more seeking. However, the good news is that this whole setup is illusory. So this whole need that something has to happen, that some realization still has to happen, is part of a dream. Nothing needs to happen, and there doesn't need to be a future realization. And in the end, there can't be, because the dream that there is someone who is unfulfilled, or that there is someone who is unfulfilled, is a dream. In that sense, one could say it's just not true. There isn't anyone who is unfulfilled. This one, this I, just isn't real. It doesn't have to be replaced with some kind of gorgeous experience. It just doesn't have to. It's whole and complete, and in that sense, fine, if you want so. Without that, exactly as it is, there is no real problem with anything already. So the natural reality is this. There isn't anything else than what seems to be happening timelessly. Now, yes, please.
Hello, Andreas.
Hello.
Help someone, defend someone physically or with word anywhere. Nothing happens. In fact, nothing has ever happened and nothing is happening.
Yes,
And nothing
exactly.
will ever happen.
Yeah.
There
Yes, it's
is
not
nothing
that.
only apparently.
Yes, yeah.
Yes.
There just is no real happening, and it won't become real either. Yeah. Yes.
There are people in this apparent world who are being tortured
Yes.
physically and mentally,
Yeah.
apparently,
Yeah.
by other people, apparently. So there is apparent suffering,
Yeah.
but nothing is happening and nothing has ever happened.
Yes, exactly. Totally. Yes. And the suffering and the torturing and that stuff is what apparently happens, but there's no answer to it. No one knows it. No one can answer it. Yes, it is nothing. It's nothing real. Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. But it's just not logical. This can't be understood. What we talk about, this being everything and this being whole and complete, whatever apparent form it takes, can't be understood. It's not logical. It doesn't make sense. Happiness in that sense doesn't make sense. Suffering doesn't make sense. Being tortured doesn't make sense. Celebrating birthday parties doesn't make sense. It's all just what seems to be happening. Can't be understood. William.
Yeah, I kind of want to share something with you, but I don't know if it will be appropriate or not, but I'll share it.
We'll see.
So yesterday, obviously, I called you after the meeting and I was pretty low. For the rest of the day, I had suicidal depression. And suddenly I had a memory of the first glimpse I had of this. And I just couldn't stop crying because I was desperately longing for that. The simplicity of it. And what kind of is coming up for me now? So what happened the first time I had it? Well, I didn't have, but the first time there was a glimpse of this, I was walking through an airport with two friends and one on either side. And one of my friends was really like hyped up. We're going abroad. My other friend was telling me all his problems with this girl that he loved. And I was in my head as a me trying to work out how to help the friend that was having problems. And suddenly there was just walking. And the simplicity of there just being walking was like, I can't even say a word about it, but there was no longer anything to work out on. No, not even a real situation happening. It was just walking. And what struck me just before I came on this Zoom meeting, thinking about having that memory yesterday, is how I can ask all these questions and you can give all these replies, but we just never be able to say what it is when there's just walking, the simplicity of nothing to work out.
Yeah, exactly. That's what we talk about here. How it is on the one hand and how it isn't experienced when there's just what happens.
Nothing will ever bring that about.
Nothing.
No amount of meetings, no amount of questioning you or whoever else. This
never. It will never be achieved. It will never be gotten. Yeah. No. There's no connection between what the person regards as its life and seeking and the not being there of this.
I don't know, the longing for that is so strong, but the me's going to...
Well, all longing is about that in the end. Of course, unconsciously, the person doesn't really know what he longs for, but
the person
is just part of that.
The person will fight that to the end.
Yeah, it will fight for its life, of course. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, how's it going?
Hi. Good. All good.
I think how shall I say it? So it's like there's this picturesque thing that is set up when a glimpse happens or something like that, that it's all good and everything is great and fine. It literally is the shit too, but it seems to be in those times, it doesn't, you know, it's just like the memory is kind of rosy about it.
Well, yeah. Yes and no. I mean, the thing is, my impression is that a glimpse, I mean, the nice thing about a glimpse is that there just is no seeking. But I know people who talk about glimpses who were in actually very normal situations. So they say that there weren't really gorgeous feelings necessarily, but
suddenly there was no
seeking anymore.
Yeah, but the shit is it too, also.
Of course.
It's also
being a me, apparently.
Yes, that's what I mean.
Yeah, of course.
That's what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I mean.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Because, but me doesn't want that.
Oh, no, of course not. Yeah, yes. Yeah, but it will never be able to want that or accept it. That's part of it. But yeah, of course.
You want some kind of a rosy version.
Exactly. Yeah. And you can't accept that itself, or separation, if you want, so is also whole and complete, because it's not its experience. It's unexpected.
I was talking to Jim this weekend, and we were saying how I felt that in the glimpses, for most, except for like maybe, I don't know, in general, there's always a discoloration of a person in there somewhere. Some trace of it or something. It doesn't matter.
Mm.
But it seems to be the case that it's just, there's something still there in there somewhere. Mm.
Yeah, why not? That's why I sometimes say that liberation is not really like a long glimpse or something.
Yeah, exactly. It's totally different. That's what I mean.
Yeah. It's the melting of all of it into something that's completely unknown and undescribable and unexpected. Because it doesn't know opposites. That's the thing. Liberation doesn't know opposites or two. Glimpse, in a glimpse, not in a glimpse. Me, no me. It's all melting into what happens. Mm.
So funny, because I've realized that it's impossible for a person to understand that there's no control at any level. It's just, it's so, even when I thought that there, you know, like, yes, there's no control, but I can this behavior, or I could ever, and it's just so beyond, completely and totally, you know, not, absolutely not controlled. And that's just unacceptable to the person completely.
Absolutely, absolutely. Because in the person's experience, there's just the impression of control. And even if it's just a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of control.
Yes, exactly.
It just feels as if I'm playing some part in all of this.
Absolutely.
Totally. And it doesn't matter how often it's heard or how much the idea is accepted that there is nothing in control. I mean, for the person, the funny thing is, for the person to even understand this concept, oh yeah, I understand, there is nothing in control, somehow confirms the impression of control. At least I could understand that concept.
Yeah.
Can't. That's just how it feels.
It's just amazing, because I'm seeing like these repeated patterns of behaviors that I'm doing, and in which I'm keeping myself in the wheel, you know?
Yeah, but in the watching of it.
Yes, whatever, it doesn't matter. Yeah. But I'm seeing it, and then I'm seeing, okay, now I'm going to stop it. And I can't fucking stop it.
Oh, no, of course not.
Crazy.
Yeah, I mean,
and I was, I've been trying to stop it, and it's ridiculous. And it makes me feel so bad that I'm doing it, but I can't stop it.
Yeah. It's there is no one, basically. Whatever you think you should stop, there isn't anyone. First you want to stop the movement, then you want to stop you wanting to stop the movement. Whatever. Yeah.
That's what I mean. Like, understanding and being clear about this message is just completely and totally irrelevant.
It has nothing to do with liberation. It has nothing to do with this being everything.
Yeah.
No connection at all, because it just doesn't happen, you know. Understanding that nothing is in control has nothing to do with their not being control, not at all. They don't meet. Somehow accepting the idea that there is no separation has nothing to do with non-separation. It just is like that.
And that's the interesting thing, is that, because I was thinking about that, is like, it's so funny that how does it infiltrate the thinking that I think that I'm some sort of independent entity that can make things happen and do things. The parent thought that I'm doing it and I can make things happen.
Yeah, I mean, my impression is what's underlying this thought, this narrative, is that it just feels like that. But in the end, there is no answer to that. How this can even be, or how this can apparently happen, so to speak. Well, that's just what seems to be happening without any source or
knowledge. It's completely nonsensical.
Not at all.
Whatsoever.
Not at all.
Holy shit.
All of it, but including this, including the illusion to be someone. It doesn't make sense. Again, as you said, with the control, it doesn't make sense on any level. There's no control on any level. Yeah.
And it's me always lives in perpetuation.
Going on.
And my hopes and dreams in the future. Yes, liberation. Not now.
No.
In the future, you know. When in the future, it's always beyond the horizon. It's always casting its fucking bait out in the...
Yeah, I mean, its experience confirms that this can't be it. So it's never not now, but also based on experience.
It's a moving energy.
Yeah.
Apparent.
Yeah.
And that's why it makes the body so tense, because... you know, nothing really is moving anywhere.
Yeah.
All right, I've talked enough.
All this, yeah. Yeah, thank you.
Andreas, you know, before when I said that no amount of questions and answers and going to meetings will ever bring that about, do you think that's why Tony says it's completely energetic what goes on in these meetings? It's nothing to do with the words.
Well, yeah, maybe.
What I mean is, well, maybe I'm just adding value or trying to find value in these meetings, perhaps. But obviously a glimpse can happen before anyone's heard of liberation or this, or someone could completely collapse apparently without this, just walking down the road or whatever it is. But for some reason, for me, in these meetings, there's a stronger resonance of whatever's can't be said, rather than just sitting here and looking at a table or a mug or something. But then again, I suppose you would say that it doesn't need conditions either.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it just doesn't matter, you know, even if it completely is, as you said, or think, but there's just no conclusion from that.
Yeah.
So, yeah,
it's just, because
it seems to be happening. There's a stronger resonance in those meetings.
And I suppose, yeah, then if I'm adding meaning to that, good to be in the meetings or something, it's just what's happening also, but it's also completely meaningless.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you.
Hi, Andreas.
Hello.
When I hear all there is what's happening, I try to put it into a personal framework.
Yeah.
And, you know, to add a description from a personal perspective. And that's really not what's said. I realize that, but you can't really say that anything's happening or nothing can be said about what's happening. It can't be described, can't be known, can't be, you know.
And in a way, even the concept that something is happening at all can't actually be known, really.
Right.
But yes.
So even as a pointer, it's useless.
Yes. It's not even a pointer, this message or this what we do here. It's not even pointing to something, actually.
When you say staring at a screen, that doesn't really mean anything. And are we even doing that? I mean, there's nobody that can say that we're staring at a screen, right?
That's why I sometimes say, even when there are words coming, nothing is being said. Mm. It's really a non-message. There is no passing on of any kind of information. And as you said, it's not even pointing to something.
No. Mm. So the message isn't really conveying anything.
Yes. Yeah. It's funny, but it is like that.
That's the beauty of it.
Yeah, kind of. I mean, if you want a story, one could say saying this is all there is pointing to itself. Right. Saying all there is all there is, so to speak. But
even saying all there is not something. It's not a, that itself is not
exactly. Really. Exactly. It's not pointing to a certain kind of reality.
Right.
Yeah, it's just.
I first heard the message. I was trying to understand it from a more, you know, from, and I realized that you can't understand it from a personal perspective because it's beyond that. But even to say anything is, I guess I just want to reiterate, even to say that anything is happening is not what's being.
Yes. Said. Exactly. Yes. Yes.
So then would you say that nothing is happening, or you say that nothing is apparent, or something is apparently happening, but in fact, it's nothing? Or
something like that. That sounds good. It's all it's all of those things. But right. It's again, not a position, you know, yeah. That nothing is happening. Who would know that again? Who could know if this is nothing or something or whatever? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Any attempt for the person to put it into a personal perspective or a personal framework is wrong from, you know, just
from actually there. Right from the start, right from even attempting to do so.
Right. Yeah.
Attempting to put in a framework is the seeking.
Right.
Not only the frustration of not having managed to put it into a framework, the seeking starts with the attempt to do that even.
Right. Oh, that's great. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Andreas.
Hello. Hi.
Hi. There was a little discussion earlier about not getting anything from these meetings.
Yes.
There's nothing to get. But I mean, isn't that true of everything? Like, there's no getting of anything. I mean, if illusionary self is not even happening, there's nothing, there's nobody to get anything. There's nothing to get. There's no getting anywhere. Yes.
Not anywhere, just anywhere, anyway. It's not special in these meetings. Oh. Yeah, really. I mean, that's the person's problem. Or one could say the person wouldn't be here if anything else would have worked before. But it didn't. Nothing happened. Nothing worked before. Nothing was ever gotten in terms of what the person is looking for. Somehow becoming more fulfilled. And the things that the person said that it did achieve, you know, sometimes you hear things, yeah, well, but I did this inquiry and I had some nice insights, as if it was at least something. No, it was nothing. It didn't give anything. It was what seemed to be happening, and there was nothing wrong with it. But regarding the sense of becoming more fulfilled, it didn't give anything, nothing, nothing.
Yeah, even the glimpses don't give anything.
Oh, not a single bit. They don't give
anything. They give a new memory. No.
Which again has nothing to do with more fulfillment. Maybe the person can dwell on that for a bit, but this would just again be occupying itself with.
Yeah, if anything, it just feeds the discontent because exactly. Now there's this comparison.
Yes, exactly. For the person, that would be likely to happen to you.
Yes, it does. I can attest to that. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thanks. I mean, that's the funny thing for the person. It all looks so precious and real. And I know for the person, it really feels as if there is something to be gotten in this world. And that it partly also worked out. But it didn't. It can't. An empty reality can't provide content, so to speak. It's impossible. And the content that the person is looking for would be value, meaning, fulfillment. And that's just not there. It's dreamt. The person has to constantly fantasize about it to feel good about itself. Fantasize, oh, this gives me something, and then be happy about it. On that, oh, great, I got something here. But there was no answering of the seeking dynamic at all and of the longing. Amazing. Yeah.
Andreas, could you say that you really, well, I suppose this still is me asking you as if you are a person, but could you really say that you have no wish for anything to change?
Well, yes, to be honest, yeah.
Because it's already complete, is that why?
Oh, well, no, because wishing or it's just part of the illusion to be someone. I mean, there isn't anyone here who is content with how it is. There's just no one there. So the ability to wish for something else just isn't there anymore. But as I said, not because there is someone who is happy with how it is. That's not needed. I'm not happy with how it is. I don't have any knowledge about this being in the first place. But I have no clue what I would wish for that it should change. And then think it would be really better if this or this would change. Not at all. It's impossible.
You have no knowledge about this being in the first place.
Yeah, of course.
That
would be the starting point for wishing. For wishing for something else, you need a now that you're aware of.
I'm sorry, it's amazing to hear you say that. Really, it feels, well, it's not about me feeling good, but it does feel good to hear you say that. But it's like, at the same time, what on earth is that? You have no knowledge of this being in the first place.
Exactly. Yeah.
That is incredible. You can't go anywhere with that.
Exactly. That's what I mean. There isn't even a starting point for seeking, for wishing, for going anywhere. Of course.
I still can't get, so.
Well, you never will get.
No, but just the so-called liberation is complete unconsciousness. Like when you were talking on the weekend about it's like you went to sleep and didn't wake up, and but the body's so animated, and you know, you are passionate and there's things you love and all the rest of it. And I'm saying you, it's the body, but to think there's absolutely nothing in there aware of any of that.
Yeah, for the person that's almost sad, but incomprehensible.
Yeah, and even to think I thought this whole time, well, I still do, that I'm relating to someone else who in my hopes is like me somehow.
Somehow, also a me, but a bit of a more successful me or something.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Maybe this is already clear for everybody, but I was just wondering again. I mean, perceptions and thoughts and feelings are just something that is apparently happening, but to nobody, no?
Yes, exactly.
And yeah, the question in itself is not correct when I ask you, do you have dreams sometimes?
Or... You mean at night?
Night, yeah.
Yes, sometimes, yeah. Yeah. Well, I can remember them. Sometimes I can remember dreams, yeah. Not very often, but it happens. Yeah.
Yes, but you also say that nothing changes.
Yeah.
That nothing has changed. So the apparent Andreas, I mean, with the wishes, the apparent Andreas might like a person, and when the person is very, I don't know, in difficult times, is depressed or so, then isn't there an effort, something that would still wish that, that the other person is getting better?
Well, not really, no. No. Sorry, but no. No, there might be a reaction from the body that, I don't know, passing a tissue or something. But there wouldn't be a narrative going on inside that I want the other one to be more happy or... No, I'm sorry. No.
Andreas, in a way, that is just freedom. I was having a conversation with Tony a couple of weeks ago about... He said something in an old video about if someone's dying of cancer and somebody walks in the room who isn't there, let's say, they're not projecting onto that person that anything needs to change or that, you know, anything's wrong with that. And so he said, when we were discussing it on the phone, he said it can be incredibly healing. Not that that needs to happen, but that there's nothing energetically projected onto that that other person that anything's wrong with their situation or it needs to change.
Yeah.
And I just think, like, compared to, not that there's anything wrong with it, but compared to how most people are when they see someone suffering and they really want to do something about it.
Well, they want to do something about it because they want that something is being done about them.
Yeah. Because they want to feel relief.
Yeah. And of course, there's this general impression of wrongs.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not that helping cannot happen anymore. I mean,
no.
It can happen apparently, but it wouldn't come out of this story that something is wrong or this impression that there is something wrong.
No, but yeah, there wouldn't be something there. I'm talking about you, like there wouldn't be something there that needs to be relieved to know that, oh, everything's fine again.
Absolutely, yeah. To be able to be fine oneself again. Yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Andreas, and if you say this is a no message, that applies to every message, to every...
Oh, absolutely. Oh, totally. People just claim that they have something to say.
Yes.
Yeah, totally. It's equally empty. No one says anything. Yeah.
Right.
They're just pretending to know something that's helpful. Well, pretending, it's not conscious, of course.
Andreas, what I find interesting is that the more I listen to this message, the less interest and even tolerance I have for, the things that I was very interested in before, which, like, you know, self-improvement and those types of things. Completely, just totally turned off by them.
Yeah, it's a turn off, of course. Yeah,
but this message, I guess maybe because it doesn't point to anything and doesn't promise anything and it's just pulls a rug from, you know, completely from the me, maybe that's why, I don't know, you know, is that why it appeals to me? And I found that, you know, I think other people that I've talked to, you know, they get gradually turned off by old, you know, by these old, you know, personal improvement.
Well, absolutely. I think because unconsciously or apparently consciously, maybe, you can sense the imprisonment that comes along with it.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
More energetic, you know, it's not a conscious thing, but of course, in all those ideas, there's just this apparent imprisonment involved. And for most people, that's the other thing. For most people, it's not just an interest, you know. I don't know how the brain works or how humans behave or something. When there is someone, this is always attached to it, you know. You just can't talk about those things for no deeper reason. For when there is someone, it's always very important and connected to the seeking energy, and that is the imprisonment.
So really, it's maybe the realization that really those messages are just imprisonment repackaged, you know, in different forms, and
absolutely promising some. They're just personal, and there's nothing wrong with that, but that's just what it is, apparently imprisoning. Of course, when there is no resonance anymore, or when there is nothing seeking anymore, then this just isn't interesting. Right. It just isn't. It's, as you said, it's even a turnoff.
Yeah, and it seems to be getting more so. You know? I think you said that when you got away from your guru, you gradually sort of had that same feeling about him. I think that's what you said. Maybe I'm mischaracterizing that.
Well, about all those things, it really doesn't make sense anymore, this whole seeking business. And the interest in those things. I mean, there's still kind of a certain interest here, for example, in human behavior and things, but that's just kind of happening at the side. It's not because I'm interested in it and think that it has any value. Not at all. It's just what happens. And it could be completely replaced with an interest for soccer or stamps or whatever. Collecting stamps now. No, I don't. So there is no value in any of that, in any kind of seeking. And in a way, being interested in certain things. I know there are so many people who want to save psychology or something. And yeah, it's not wrong. Nothing is wrong. But this possibility that there is a self which needs to work on itself, that's just, there's nothing wrong with it. But that is the apparent prison, so to speak. Thank you.
Because I think that just saying nothing is nothing has meaning. Yeah, this is also an attitude. I can just try to sit there and tell myself nothing is
useful. Yeah, but that's not what I talk about. Then having this attitude becomes very meaningful. So.
Yes, or just say, I know nothing. Interesting. I numb myself. I make myself kind of.
Yeah, but who would know that nothing is interesting? So yeah, that's not what I talk about. A position.
No position. Yeah.
That would be. But as I said, this position then would become very interesting and seem meaningful. So.
Yeah, I mean the position of meaninglessness.
Or, exactly.
Would that? Or like thinking, oh no, I managed not to be have any. Yeah, nothing gets me anymore. So this is again, the me makes another thing out of it.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's a very boring place to be in. Thank you. All right, so that's about it. There is no message. There is no one. There is no separation. No one has lost anything. And what happens is just naturally perfect. It's this. That's the natural perfection, if you want. So it's no one's. no one's experiencing it, no one's owning it and all those things. But it doesn't need that, of course. This doesn't need to be personal. This doesn't need to happen for someone. It's totally fine being blindly and wildly itself. Thank you very much for joining. I wish you a lovely day. Thank you. Nice to see you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrea.